So to use a function machine, we have to start with our input on the left-hand side and then follow the operations from left to right. So for this first function machine, we'd start with our input, we'd then multiply by 5, and then we would subtract 3 to get our output. So for part A to this question, we need to figure out the output when the input is 8. So I'm going to start off by writing 8 by the input, and then I'm just going to follow these operations. So I'd do 8 multiplied by 5, well, that would give me 40, so that would go here. We then need to do 40 take away 3, which would give us 37, and that would be our output. So when our input is 8, our output is 37. And we're going to do exactly the same thing for this next function machine. We have our input, we then have to add 11, we then subtract 4, and that will give us our output. So for part B, we need to figure out the output when the input is negative 3. So we're starting with an input of negative 3. We then have to add 11, well, that would give us positive 8, so that's going to go there. We then need to do 8 take away 4, well, that'll give us 4. So when our input is negative 3, our output will be 4. And that's all we need to do when we're looking for an output of a function machine is start with the input and follow the steps from left to right. Let's have a look at another example. So we've got a new function machine this time. We start with our input, we then have to multiply by 4, we then subtract 7, and that gives us our output. So for part A, what is the output when the input is 9? So I'm going to put that at the top. So we follow it from left to right. We have to do 9 multiplied by 4, well, that's 36. We then do 36 take away 7, well, that gives us 29. So when our input is 9, our output is 29. But for part B, we have to figure out the input when we're told that the output is 25. So when using a function machine where we're given the output, when we're working from right to left, we have to do the opposite operations. So I'm going to write these numbers underneath the function machine. So we're starting with an output of 25. But now because we're moving from right to left, we have to do the opposite operation. So instead of doing subtract 7, we have to do the opposite operation here, so we have to add 7. So 25 plus 7 gives us 32. And then again, because we're working backwards, this time instead of doing multiply by 4, we have to do the opposite operation. So here we would be dividing by 4. So if we do 32 divided by 4, that's going to give us an input of 8. And we can check our answer, because if the input is 8, we can now work from left to right, so we can follow the steps in the normal way that they were written. So we would do 8 multiplied by 4, which gives us 32, which then when we take away 7, does in fact give us 25. So we know we've got the correct answer. When the output is 25, the input is 8. So the key takeaway here is that when we've got a function machine and we're given the output, we have to work backwards and do the opposite operations. Okay, let's take a look at one final example. So for this function machine, we're starting with our input, we're then multiplying by 5, we're then adding 7. So for part A, we're figuring out the output when we're given an input of 6. So we're following this from left to right. So we're starting with this 6, and the first step is we need to multiply by 5. Well, if we do 6 multiplied by 5, that's going to give us 30. We then take that 30 and we add on our 7. So 30 plus 7 is going to give us 37. So when the input is 6, the output would be 37. Then for part B to this question, we need to figure out what is the output when the input is negative 4. So again, we're going from left to right again. So we use the operations that we were originally given. So we're starting with negative 4. we then have to multiply this by 5. Well, negative 4 times 5 is going to give us negative 20. We then take that negative 20 and we have to add 7. So negative 20 plus 7 is going to give us negative 13. So when our input is negative 4, our output will be negative 13. And then for part C, we have to figure out the input when the output is 52. So we're working backwards this time. So again, we're going to have to do the opposite operations. So we're starting with 52 by the output. And instead of adding 7, we're going to be doing the opposite operation. So we'll be subtracting 7 at this point. So if we do 52 take away 7, that's going to give us 45. And then instead of doing multiply by 5, we have to do the opposite. So we'll be dividing by 5. So when we do 45 divided by 5, that's going to give us 9. So when the output is 52, the input would be 9. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for this video. If you want to check out any other videos relevant to this one, then I'll leave some links for them down in the description, and I'll also put a card in the top corner. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any other topics that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.